Hey everybody, my name is Rob Woodbridge from Untethered.tv. What you're about to see here is a clip, a short clip of a much longer episode that can be found on Untethered.tv. So if you really are interested in this, go to Untethered.tv, do a search for this title, and you'll find it there. But enjoy this short clip.
You know, our viewpoint is that there are two things that have changed the current landscape of retail. One is Amazon and one is mobile. And they're somewhat related, but they are very separate. And there are trends that are changing the way consumers are buying and the way the consumers are engaging with information. And mobile is that, that on-the-go device that really digitizes or has the opportunity to digitize the very analog in-store shopping experience. And Amazon, of course, is the 800-pound gorilla that competes effectively on price, where you can basically buy from Amazon on the go on your mobile phone or via the web for a much cheaper price. So our business is really catering to that integrated retail marketplace, where Amazon is pure play e-commerce, and we don't actually cater to the Amazons of the world. And we feel that actually the retail model that will win the day is an integrated retail model where you have a physical retail presence, but it is tightly integrated with e-commerce and mobile commerce in a way that is consistent, which nobody really is doing well today. And that is one of the biggest issues, and why Amazon is a pure play is giving every retailer a run for their money because of the siloed nature of retail. But for us, it's about that mobile engagement, mobile customer. Mobile has created all of these interstitial stops along the way to the purchase journey, where now it's at least measurable. And without mobile, the real situation was all the digital engagement happened at your home, and then you went to the store, and marketers didn't know anything in between.
Right.
And now marketers have the opportunity to learn almost everything in between. And that's one of the big reasons that mobile has been so disruptive, and I think is a huge part of our business, from a promotion standpoint and location-based is a killer theme here for our business. And I'm happy to, get into that and how we think about that.
You brought up so much. I love this because, I think about that statement that you said is that from the consumer standpoint, from our standpoint, 5.5 years ago, before 2007, we'll say, I mean, I carried a BlackBerry, I had a Palm Pilot, a connected device, whatever you want to call it. But really, you're right. I made a decision here, sitting in front of my screen, and then I made the buy decision, and I either bought there because e-commerce was around at that point. We're not talking dinosaur era. And then I would get in my car, and I would drive to the store, and I would pick it up from that store that I just saw it here, right? Wherever it was, I would go and get it. So that's the old way. But now I've done my research on here. I'm either buying it online or I'm driving to a store that I'll pick it up later. Maybe I'll go down to Best Buy or whatever it might be. And in between the time that I leave and the time that I actually step foot in Best Buy, there are many interaction opportunities for other brands to go and steal that money from Best Buy and bring me into the store. That is a huge thing. That are a lot of companies, building this into their marketing philosophy?
Well, it's a fun topic of conversation. I can tell you the answer is mostly no, and it depends. The mostly no is that the world of location-based marketing is something that brands understand from a holistic standpoint and why it's valuable for them to reach their customer. And location-based marketing, of course, has the opportunity to provide competitive marketing, which is what you articulated. Right, so it's the stealing or the competitive targeting of offer to consumer, and people will use Lowe's and Home Depot. I know I'm going to Home Depot, so Lowe's hits me with a targeted GPS right. message, and I get compelled to drive to Lowe's. But frankly, what I've seen is marketers being more resistant to that type of marketing because it actually can backfire. And the way that it backfires is very simple. That what they're trying to do is it's disruption marketing, which a lot of digital marketers will claim is on the way out in today's day and age. And ultimately what you're doing is potentially targeting a loyal Home Depot customer with an incentive which will never be rich enough to get them to go to Lowe's, and you actually create a negative brand experience where consumers feel like they're being bombarded from, you know, a retailer that they're not loyal to. And that type of disallegiance or you know, repulsion in some cases is a risk that many marketers don't want to take. And that's where they look at location-based marketing more around their core customer base. And they'll look at, you know, the radius around their own stores rather than around competitor stores. There's definitely the competitive targeting happening, but based on some I think early testing, and it will continue to be tested, and competitive targeting exists in every other medium, and this opens up another opportunity. But what we're hearing and seeing is that there is a bit of that psychological consumer psychology that is indicating to brands that it's not a slam dunk home run, that it needs to be done very selectively and very with very informed decisions in order to make sure that it doesn't backfire.